gents who's come about then?
Darryl's pension.
Darryl's pension? Blimey, Trace, he's only 36. I ain't about to give him a pension.
His pension plan. What he used to pay into.
Oh. She know about Darryl then?
No. I said he was working in California.
What'd you say that for?
Because it sounds better than saying he's banged up for armed robbery. What do you think?
You see, what I'm concerned about is that things rather came to a stop a few years ago.
Yeah, things did come to a bit of a stop then.
Mr. Stubbs made some sort of career move.
Yeah, you could say that, sort of.
I'm worried about all these years going by with nothing in them.
You're telling me.
Of course, a few years ago, Mr. Stubbs did put in that very large sum. But then all of a sudden, he sort of stopped.
Yes.
Yes?
What, a very large sum? Sort of sudden-like?
Yes. He came into some money, I expect.
Well, yes, in a way. A lot of money did come his way. Passed through his hands, sort of thing. But I wasn't clear about what happened to it all. Not entirely.
Ah, but as I say, nothing since 1989. And we were afraid that there'd been an oversight.
How much was it for, this payment in 1989?
1989?
Yeah, this big chunk. How much was it exactly?
No. The large payment was made in 1988.
Oh, no, it couldn't have been. It was 1989 when he'd done the job. I mean, had the big contract, you know.
His 1989 payment was perfectly normal. It was in 1988 that he made the major contribution.
Oh, yeah. There it is, blimey.
You'll be seeing him soon?
Oh, yeah. Every 2 weeks, never miss.
Such an awful journey for you.
Oh, it ain't so bad. Tube to Victoria, then the train.
I meant the flight.
What flight? Oh, the flight to California, after Victoria and the train to Heathrow, that flight. Well, you get used to it. Ain't so bad if they show a good film.
He'll be there a long time, will he?
Years.
Oh, Lord. So awful separation, isn't it?
You're not kidding.
Poor you. It must seem like a prison sentence.
Well, this is going to roll up to an absolute packet.
That's what I'm worried about.
Oh, yeah. Must be heartbreaking, though. Knowing you're going to be rich. You must be half distracted with it.
What I mean, Miss Sark Attack 1993, is where did the money come from?
Well, Darryl is a convicted bank robber. This is a large and unexplained sum of money. Using your skill and judgment, put two and two together.
He done no bank robbing then. He only did one job and he got banged up for it. He wouldn't lie to me.
Where else could it have come from?
Well, the business, I suppose.
Well, look at the accounts for that year.
Why?
It'll give us a clue. I mean, it has to be explained somehow, doesn't it? It can't appear on his tax return as income from armed robbery, can it?
You can't rely on tax returns, Dor. They won't necessarily tell you anything.
I'm an accountant's wife, Sharon. I'm well aware of the approximate nature of tax returns. Marcus files his clients' accounts under fiction and non-fiction, drama, documentary and myths and legends. Nonetheless, it's a starting point.
I will look at his accounts, you're right.
Good.
I'll look later.
Right. Why don't you...
What?
You know, look now. I don't mind.
I think that's something I should do on my own, it being Darryl's private business and that.
Oh, yes. Quite. If...
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, accounts are not always the easiest of things to follow. If you do need my help, I would be only too delighted. I do have some experience in these matters.
Oh, that's really nice of you, Dor.
Tar very much.
Yeah.
We'll let you know if we do. Yes. Well. You tried them new corn burgers with the crispy crumb coating they got down Sainsbury's door? We had them last night. They're really tasty, aren't they, Shell?
Yeah, they are. You should give them a go.
Shut up! You miserable pair of smug, smirking, common little cockneys. I'd like to crispy crumb the pair of you.
What?
I? Leading me on about your tuckney, hapney little mystery, exciting my interest, then shutting me out like I'm just some nosy neighbour.
Well, you are, Dor.
Well, why did you tell me about it in the first place, then? Leading me on only to cast me aside. There are names for girls like you. You'd just better hope you never need my help in the future. That's all I can say. Corn burgers.
Ooh!
What's sundries?
I don't know, but they're dead pricey. Spent a packet on them. This and that, I suppose.
No, this and that's miscellaneous. You spent a packet on them and all.
Small this and that, tips and that.
No, he done tips and gratuities here. He spent enough on tips and gratuities to open a couple of restaurants and a small cab rank.
It was a business, he had expenses.
Yeah, well, I don't reckon he got this money bank robbing anyway.
Why not?
Because according to this, he'd have claimed for shotgun cartridges, stocking masks and wear and tear on the getaway car.
Well, it ain't here, is it?
Well, I can't see it.
I don't get it. He wouldn't lie about his pension contributions because they let you off tax for them. So where is it?
Well, it must be here somewhere. With computations, depreciations and what's name.
Oh, I can't make head nor tail of that.
Neither can I.
But you know a woman who can.
Nice big plate of humble pie, Trace. Go down a treat.
I think Marcus would have done a little better on sundries. Very modest sundries, it seems to me. Well, that all seems shipshape and professional.
Well?
Well, what?
Where's the pension contribution?
Oh, that won't be here.
Why not?
These are 1989's accounts.
Well, he put it in 1989.
Exactly. So you need 1990s accounts. An accountant can't do the accounts till the year's over, can he?
Of course not.
Oh, no.
You need tax year 1990 to 91. May I?
Please do.
Ah, there it is.
There it is.
Yeah.
Capital gains, NQ.
Income tax, NQ.
Corporation tax, NQ. What's all that mean?
What's it all mean, Dor?
Oh, well, I'd have to examine the whole document very carefully to answer that, and I don't really think I should. It being your private business. I wouldn't want to pry in any way.
Fair's fair, Dorian. I think we're done grovelling. Tracy gave you a really good telephone grovel to get you to come over here. Then we went into Super Deluxe Mega Grovel Hyperdrive for at least 10 minutes to get you to look at the accounts. I'm dead sorry we were rude. I apologise. But I think we are getting dangerously close to overplaying our hand here.
I'm sorry I shut you out, Dor. I apologise. I'm really sorry. Now, button up and get your mince pies on that and tell us where it came from.
NQ means non-qualifying. It's free of all tax because he inherited it. It's a bequest. There.
He inherited it?
Who from?
He never mentioned it.
Who from?
Who from?
Henry Michael Stapleton.
Who's he?
Who's he?
Strange to relate, I have no idea.
Well, see what that... This geezer wanted a massive great conservatory, but he was jibbered a bit about the price.
Yeah.
So I said, if it's a cash job, we could do it cheaper, because it wouldn't go through the books, and I wouldn't have to pay tax on it. And I give him a bit of a wink.
Oh, yeah.
Snag was, he was a tax inspector.
What did he say?
Said he'd never heard of anything like it before.
What, he'd never heard of a builder wanting cash?
No, he'd never heard of a conservatory as cheap as that. We did his, one for his mum, two for his brother-in-law, and it led on to a load of work.
Blimey.
So we all made a load of dosh, and this tax inspector says, why don't you put it in a pension scheme? You pay less tax on the money that goes through the books, kosher. And I said, yeah, but I mean, they're going to say, where's all this dosh come from?
And what did he say?
He said, why don't you inherit it? And I looks at him a bit baffled, and he gives me a bit of a wink.
A wink like that?
Yeah, just like that, yeah. And I suddenly realised how an ordinary grade 2 tax inspector can afford a 4-bedroom Totteridge with a conservatory the size of a ballroom stuck on the back. He's into dodgy legacies. So we give him a bit of a drink and he fixes us up with Uncle Henry. God rest his soul. It's a nice little scheme, that, Trace. Should be worth a quarter mil when the time comes.
You sure you didn't rob another bank?
Trace, I'm telling you the truth. You don't believe me, ask Chris. He was in on it.
Chris?
First time we worked together. I give him a little present. Not sure what he did with it.
What? Well, that's what he said.
What did he do with it?
How should I know?
What did you do with it?
You know, wasn't that much. I never got anything like as much as Dal. But he just gave me a bit of a drink sort of thing, you know.
How much?
Well, wasn't a lot, you know.
How much?
Well, it was a long time ago, Shell.
How much?
Well, I don't remember exactly.
To the nearest thousand.
Oh, no. No. Wasn't anything like as much as that.
Wasn't it? Perhaps I'd better ask Daryl.
Oh, well, maybe it was. Probably. Nearly a thousand.
Chris.
Well, say a couple. No more.
2 grand.
No more than 5, Shell, on my life.
£5,000?
Shell.
5 grand? 5 frigging grand? Even Oliver Reed wouldn't call that a bit of a drink. What did you do with it?
Well,
Daryl puts his into a pension plan. They got a quarter of milk to look forward to. What did you do with our 5 grand?
Well, you know.
No. No, Chris, no. We done ums, we done wells, we done your nose. We've had enough of them now. Now we are moving on to plain, simple English. With proper made-up words and straightforward sentences. Like, well, Shell, I was knocking off this bimbo with big knockers at the time. She asked me nicely, so I gave her the money. Or...
How'd you find that out?
What?
Oh, kill that, Daryl.
I don't believe this.
Look, Sharon...
What am I saying? Of course I believe this.
Look, I never gave it to her.
Oh, really? She earned it, did she? Her services rendered, was it?
Oh, leave it out, Shell. Look, I invested it with her.
What?
Well, she's a financial advisor, you know.
You invested 5 grand with some woman?
Yeah.
What did you invest it in exactly?
Well, it's complicated. Bonds, trusts and what's names? All done abroad for tax reasons. It's very high powered, you know.
Ooh, sounds sensational. Thank God you never did nothing low-powered with it. Like putting it into a proper pension plan like that fool Daryl did.
Look, Sharon.
What was her name?
Annalise Morovia. Oh. Well, look, I'm not absolutely certain that was her real name, to tell you the truth. She sort of skipped off. I kind of lost touch. Well, that's why I never told you before. You know, I was done. She went totally missing. Look, loads of people would like to know where she is.
Have you got anything to prove that you actually own this investment?
Well, she said she'd hang on to all that for me. Save me losing it.
Dead helpful, weren't she? Wait here.
I ain't going nowhere, girl. Not for 4 years, 2 months and 9 days, I ain't.
Yeah, I remember her. We'd done her a conservatory. He never slept with a shell.
Didn't he?
Nah, no way. He wanted to. That's why he was cracking on he was a big-time investor. But we're talking a class bird here. And Chris ain't got no chance of a class bird, has he?
Oh, I'm sorry, Shane. No, Dix.
Mind you, it's Chris's money, isn't it, Shell?
Of course it ain't. It's half mine. We were married. He couldn't have done the work without me. I did his housework, his laundry, everything. I'd even have given him his conjugal rights if he wanted them. Of course it's mine.
Well, he seemed to put half of southern England under glass.
Well, he was doing well.
Oh, that's a nice brochure. That is well done. Very upmarket.
No need to sound so surprised.
I've got it. Here it is. Miss Annalise Morovia, one conservatory as per plan. Woodside Close.
What number?
Doesn't say.
Shame we can't get round the back to see, like.
Well, we can't. So, ring on a bell, show them the brochure and say, is there a conservatory like this in the street?
I think we're burglars on a recce.
If only we could get round the back to see for ourselves.
We've tried and we can't, Mum.
Now, whatever happens, don't ask to see Annalise Morovia.
Why not?
Because they might alert her, or it might even be her and she'll pretend to be someone else.
Well, what do we say then?
Well, we adopt some ruse.
We could say we was from the District Surveyor's Office, come to inspect the conservatory.
5 years after it was put in.
We've got a terrible backlog because of the recession.
We've had less of a backlog in a recession.
No, local councils always have a terrible backlog. I mean, they're hopeless incompetent, especially this one. It's Labour, bound to be a disaster.
What?
I said local...
Excuse me. Excuse me, Labour, a disaster? Excuse me while I die laughing. Who were the clowns that gave this country the worst recession in history, eh?
The recession is a worldwide phenomenon. Labour councils are famously useless. Paying people to stay home on the sick, running up huge debts, erecting day centres for disabled black lesbians.
Now, look...
I'll shut it, you two. This ain't question time. Garth's too young to be a district surveyor anyway.
All right. One of us will have to do it then.
Oh, no. They'll expect it to be a man.
Why? Why should it be a man? It makes me sick, that. There's no reason a woman can't be a...
Oh, don't launch into a great feminist diatribe, Sharon. We do not wish to raise suspicion. The average person would expect the district surveyor to be a man.
She's right, Shell.
Yes. Well, the average person would expect the district surveyor to be over 18.
Say you are from the district surveyor's office. You just have a foothold in the conservatory's department. Most council employees are dreadful, spotty schoolboys. No one else will employ anyway. It'll be fine. I'm sorry, Garth. I mean, I didn't... Oh, you know what I mean.
Well, how come I don't already know the number of the house if I'm from the district surveyor's office?
Because you lost the number.
Well, how did I lose it?
There was a fire in the office.
It would have been in the papers.
A very small fire. You know the street, you don't know the number.
I haven't got a tie. I ain't got a tie on you, have you, Mum?
Amazingly, no, I haven't.
I should have a tie. If I'm from the district surveyor's office.
There's an Oxfam shop round the corner.
Is there?
Give me strength.
I'll see what they got.
Bluey green would be nice, Mum. Go with my new jacket.
Yeah.
Or red, if they got a plummy sort of red.
Right.
Trace, while you're there, have a quick shufty, see if they've got anything decent in a size 20, will you?
Don't get stripes. I don't like stripes.
Look, just buy him a tie. Any tie, please.
See if they've got a clipboard or a spirit level or something. Make it look more convincing.
Oh, of course. Yes. Get him a theodolite with a brass tripod. Hard hat. Cartwheel with a bit of rag tie round it. Let us not send him on this hazardous mission without the proper equipment.
No need to be sarky.
Look, all we want to do is find out where this wretched conservatory is. Is all this input from wardrobes and props really necessary? It's like being on location with Steven Spielberg. I think we could get round the back to have a look. Shut up, Tracy!
Ain't bad, that toy, is it?
It's horrible, Mum. Now, what shall I say?
Say these conservatories are liable to fall down unless they have a modification.
What if they're the ones what got the conservatory? When they don't get their modification, they might phone the council. And before we know it, we'll have the old Bill round here looking for a bloke in a naff tie who's been acting suspicious.
Yeah, and they don't say much for my Darrell's conservatories neither.
I can cover that. If they have got it, I'll say, aha, a stub stalwart. These are the finest conservatories in the land. You got no worries with this one.
Well done, Garth. A masterstroke. I am quite weak with admiration. Now, would you please go and ring a bell and find out where this sodding glasshouse is? So we can have some hope of finding this woman before it's time to start drawing the wretched pension.
Good afternoon, madam. I'm from the...
Not today, thank you.
No, you see, I'm from the...
What are you selling anyway?
Nothing.
What's that?
Well, this is why I'm here. You see, I'm from the...
I don't want one of those.
No, you see, I'm from the...
Hate the things. Woman in number 9's got one of those. Exactly like that. Some appalling thug put it in. He went to prison, you know. Don't you?
How'd it go?
She fell for it a treat. Number 9.
So now what?
Well, either the Morovia woman is in there or someone who may well have a forwarding address.
But they're hardly likely to just give it to someone that knocks on the door, are they?
Well, we'll have to adopt another Rose. We'll have a family of them before long.
I've got an idea.
Oh, good. Will it involve us in purchasing outfits of clothes and lorry loads of equipment?
Good afternoon. We represent Stubbs Conservatories, clearly the best. We're looking for Ms. Annalise Morovia.
Oh, well, she doesn't live here anymore.
You see, she's won a prize.
And we need to find her.
I'm from the District Surveyor's Office, Conservatories Department. We're the judging panel.
Made up of a representative cross-section of society. I'm an ordinary housewife.
I'm a single working class woman.
And I represent the more upmarket element.
And she's won, you say?
Yes.
But she had the conservatory put in more than 5 years ago.
There was a bank
with the Labour Council lost the papers. There were various delays. Do you have a forwarding address for her?
Oh, yes, here it is. Can't seem to find it. Oh, well, it doesn't matter. It's in the phone book.
What?
The phone book?
Yes, here it is.
Or did you want her business address? That's in this directory.
Business address?
Oh, yes. Annalise Morovia Investments, PLC. I had to look it up once.
What's she won, exactly?
Oh, yes. Oh, this one. How can I help you, Mrs. Theodopolopoulos?
Well, I want to know what it's worth, don't I?
But you see, this is your husband's pension scheme.
He's in prison, Miss Moravia. He's a useless, lying scumbag, and I gave him 7 years of my life. What's his is mine.
He was a builder, wasn't he?
Sort of. He done building, laying about and bank robbing. There are better career plans. And if you could take exams for getting your leg over, he'd have got full marks for effort.
Oh, yes, I remember him now.
And absolutely nothing for the coursework. Believe me, what's his is definitely mine.
Mr. Theodopolopoulos wouldn't take my advice at the time. So much so that I got him to sign this declaration.
What's this Northern Recovery Fund?
Oh, that was my suggestion for him. He'd have trebled his money.
But he didn't do this one.
No, he did this. Investment in various companies, including BCCI, Polymer, and Robert Maxwell's offshore holdings. It's just as well he didn't have the money to be a name at Lloyd's, or he'd have gone for that as well.
He couldn't have just done those three.
Oh, good Lord, no. But that does give you an idea of the quality of the investments. No, he went for an enormous number of tiny holdings. It's the most expensive way to trade.
So there's hardly any left.
Well,
look, however small it is, it's mine and I'm having it.
Mrs. Theodopolopoulos, all that is left is a bill for £210 brokerage charges. Plus interest. We've been trying to get in touch with Mr. Theodopolopoulos for years. Now, could you let me have a check now or shall we invoice you? What'll I do?
When I'm alone with only dreams of you that won't come true, what'll I do? That